Welcome. Today we will finally learn if certain events can occur in infinity despite the decreasing chances. Last time, we established the first half of the Borel Cantelli lemma. It says that if the series of probabilities of events is convergent, then the probability that these events will keep happening is zero. But what happens if the series is divergent? The second half of the Borel-Cantelli lemma says that if these events are independent, the probability of these events happening forever is one. To prove that statement, we will need one useful inequality. 1 plus x is less or equal than the exponent of x. To convince ourselves that this is the case, let's look at the graph of both functions. 1 plus x is actually tangent to exp of x for x equals 0. Otherwise, it lies below. So this approximation is precise around zero and becomes equality at this point. It is also useful to think about Taylor's expansion of the exponent function. I encourage you to prove this inequality for all real x. We will use it to prove the Borel-Cantelli lemma. So this is our goal, to prove that no matter how big number n we take, the probability that there will always be a higher number for which Bernoulli trial is successful is 1. To prove this is equivalent to proving that the complementary event has got probability 0. So what is the complementary event? That there exists a big number n beyond which all the trials are unsuccessful. Here I denote ek as an event of successful trial and ekc as a complementary event, so an unsuccessful trial. Let's arbitrarily choose number n and see what is the probability that all trials beyond it are unsuccessful. Now we will use our first assumption that all the trials are independent. If they are independent, the probability of their intersection is the product of probabilities of each of them being unsuccessful. This is equal to 1 minus probability of a successful trial. Now we can use our inequality, that 1 plus x is less or equal to exponent of x. We substitute for x equal to minus probability of success, which is a number close to 0. So the approximation is going to be quite precise. And here is why it's useful to use this inequality. The product of exponential function is the exponential function of the sum. So what is our exponent here? It is the tail of probability series. Under our second assumption, that the series is divergent, this quantity will be going to minus infinity, at which point exponent is 0. So we proved that probability of having a point beyond which all trials are unsuccessful is zero. We choose the point n arbitrarily, which means that this probability is zero for all n. So it's also zero for the sum of all n. This is equivalent to say that for any natural number, the probability of getting a success trial beyond it is 1. There we go. We proved the second half of the Borel Cantelli lemma. Emil Borel, who was one of the mathematicians after whom this lemma is named, proposed an interpretation of this result. It's called infinite monkey theorem. It says that if you put a monkey in front of a typewriter and you let it type letters at random to infinity, at some point it will produce a series of signs that will be complete works of William Shakespeare with probability 1. In fact, it will produce it infinitely many times. And not only William Shakespeare's, but also any authors you can pick in your favorite. The reason is that the probability of this event, of producing complete series of Shakespeare's work, while extremely small, it is constant, so the series is divergent. It is actually a similar case to the geometric distribution. Let's apply Borel Cantelli lemma to see if this distribution is well defined. We defined it as a number of unsuccessful Bernoulli trials before the first successful one. We were interested in the event of getting a successful trial. The Bernoulli trials are independent, so the first assumption of the Borel-Cantelli lemma is satisfied. The series of probabilities is in fact series of constant numbers. If we add constant numbers infinite number of times, we get infinity. So the second assumption of Borel-Cantelli lemma is also satisfied. Therefore, the probability that we will have successful trials in this series is 1. So the geometric distribution is well defined. At last we have the answer to this question. Successful trials will be happening over and over again in this geometric series. Let's quickly recap what we used to prove the second part of the lemma. First of all, we used complementary event, so the one that happens if and only if its complementary event does not happen, like success and failure in Bernoulli trial. We also said that the sum of probability of an event happening and the event not happening is equal to 1, quite obviously. We also said how to translate such a complicated event into its complementary event. It is exactly the same how you would negate a logical expression, inverting all quantifiers. Intersection becomes sum, sum becomes intersection, and the event is negated. We also use the fact that for independent events, probability of the product is the same as product of probabilities. You see, even the signs are similar here. And finally, we use the inequality that we mentioned in the beginning. I would recommend that you go through the logic of the proof again and watch the video again if something is not clear. If something is still not clear, feel free to ask questions in the comments section. In the next episode, we will see the Borel Cantelli lemma in action in R. I'll see you then.